In this video, let us look at episcleritis. So basically, we are looking at what? Episcleritis, something before the sclera proper. Before the sclera proper, you have something called as episcleritis. So we will look at the inflammation of that episclera. So that is episcleritis. So what is episclera, guys? So whatever you're seeing here is the sclera, right? This white part is the sclera. So here you can see sclera, right? So the sclera, whatever you're seeing, that has before it, see, this is the sclera proper. Before it, you have the episclera, right? You have what? Episclera. In front of the episclera, you have the Tenon's capsule, and then you have the bulbar conjunctiva in front of it. So what you should focus here is the inflammation of the episclera is called as episcleritis, right? Inflammation of this episclera will be episcleritis. So before the episclera, what do you have? The Tenon capsule and the bulbar conjunctiva, and behind it you have the sclera proper. So what is this episclera? It is a dense vascularized layer. So here you can see it's a very thin layer, but it has lot of vascularity. Here they've shown a lot of blood vessels, right? So inflammation of this will be episcleritis. So this episclera is a dense vascularized layer of connective tissue which covers the sclera proper. There will be fine fibroblasts, macrophages and lymphocytes in this layer. What will be there here? Fibroblasts, macrophages, lymphocytes. So inflammation of that episclera will become episcleritis, and that can involve the overlying Tenon's capsule. It affects commonly women. So why does this get inflamed? Because of idiopathic reasons and some other systemic reasons like gout, rosacea, psoriasis, connective tissue disorders, hypersensitivity reaction. Also, you can remember hypersensitivity reaction, mainly idiopathic, you should know. Okay. Idiopathic, mainly you should know. So, infectious causes, etc. Remember, here there is no autoimmune cause. That is what is important that you have to focus on. There is no autoimmune cause. Because that autoimmune cause, usually that rheumatoid arthritis, SLE, that affects the sclera. So here you should remember there is no autoimmune cause. Okay. So what are the causes of this episcleritis? Idiopathic, hypersensitivity, other systemic diseases like gout, etc. Here what happens? There will be lymphocytic infiltration of the episcleral tissue. Edema will be there. Congestion of the conjunctiva and the Tenon's capsule. So here again, types you have in the episcleritis, you have a simple type and nodular type. Simple, you can see here, it is almost coming from the limbus, right? What are they seeing here? They run in radial direction. That is simple. Nodular, you can see here, this is actually away from the limbus. Okay, you can see it is away from the limbus. The first one is very close to the limbus and it's coming radially. Nodular is away from the limbus. Okay, and there will be nodule firm, tender, and it can be moved separately from the sclera, and the overlying conjunctiva also moves freely. Okay, so what will be there here? Nodules which are firm and they are away from the limbus. Firm and tender. Firm and tender. And here that this nodule, etc., are away from the limbus. FROM. Okay. This is a very important topic for exam, guys, episcleritis. So clinical features, mainly you have to remember here is no pain. The patient absolutely has no pain, idiopathic cause, no pain. And actually there is no need of treatment also, it self-resolves. So the patient usually comes for the redness, and what will be there here? Redness. There will be mild ocular discomfort, mild photophobia, everything is mild. And what are the signs you will elicit? We told you, right, it can be simple or nodular. And what you can see is there is some 10% phenylephrine test. So this will cause blanching. Why? Because this is more superficial, isn't it? Episcleritis is more superficial, so there can be blanching. So that time you will know it is not, if it becomes white after putting this phenylephrine, you will know it is more superficial and that it is episcleritis and not scleritis. Scleritis will be very, very painful. But this one, episcleritis, is not painful. Clinical course, it resolves spontaneously. So there is something here called as recurrence. So it can recur a lot, and there is a word here called as fleeting, rarely a fleeting type of disease, episcleritis periodica. Okay, this is the terminology they are using. Recurrence, episcleritis periodica. So those are the clinical features, signs, symptoms, everything we saw. Differential diagnosis, you will have to differentiate it from other things. Simple episcleritis, you can confuse it with conjunctivitis. Nodular episcleritis, you may think that it is a inflamed pingucula, right? Inflamed pingucula, or there could be a foreign body itself which is there in the bulbar conjunctiva, or you should know whether it is scleritis or episcleritis. Pingucula, you have seen, actually it is something that involves the conjunctiva, right? So you should be able to differentiate these conditions. Scleritis, remember, it will be painful. It will be very painful. There will be no blanching when you put phenylephrine, etc. How will you treat episcleritis? It is self-resolving within like a few weeks, days, 2 weeks. Otherwise, you can give topical NSAIDs just to relieve, just for some relief. Remember, mainly whatever treatment we are talking about here is topical. Okay, because it is a little more superficial than actual scleritis. So here you should remember the word is topical. So other than the standard things, you can try topical mild corticosteroids, mild, remember the word here is mild, artificial tears, cold compress, systemically usually they are not talking about unless these don't work properly. Or actually they are saying these are in recurrent cases. For recurrent cases, they are giving it the same topical NSAIDs replaced with systemic NSAIDs. Okay. So scleritis, episcleritis versus scleritis, we have a separate video, isn't it? So, anyways, just let's look off here also. Episcleritis, no pain. Scleritis, pain, very painful. This one, there will be blanching with phenylephrine. Scleritis, there will be no blanching. Episcleritis, redness, right? And in scleritis, usually there will be violet color and there will be scleral edema in scleritis. And here the treatment is topical. Here the treatment will be systemic treatment. This episcleritis causes idiopathic. Remember, scleritis, it is rheumatoid arthritis, SLE, etc. Autoimmune conditions, very important to remember. Okay. There is a separate video on the differences between episcleritis and scleritis. Join us in the next video. Bye-bye.